Dizziness, it's a sensation that can be challenging to describe. Imagine feeling like you're spinning, swaying, or tilting, even when you're standing still. That's what we call vertigo. In this video, we're going to explore the world of vertigo, what it means, its symptoms, and its common causes. Coming up, I'm Dr. John, board certified in internal medicine as well as geriatric medicine. This channel is here to promote your health and your well-being. Think your health. Let's start by understanding the symptoms of vertigo. If you have vertigo, you might feel like you're spinning, tilting, or swaying. These sensations can be intermittent, lasting for seconds to hours, or even days. You might also experience nausea, vomiting, headaches, and sensitivity to light and noise. In some cases, vertigo can lead to double vision, difficulty speaking, and weakness. If you're curious whether you have vertigo, it's crucial to pay attention to these symptoms. These can provide valuable clues for diagnosis. One of the frequent culprits is benign paroxysmal positional vertigo, or BPPV. This condition occurs due to misplaced calcium collections in the inner ear, leading to brief episodes of vertigo. These are often triggered by head movements. BPPV typically resolves on its own, but can be effectively treated through the Epley maneuver. How does this maneuver work and how does it help? The Epley maneuver, it's like a special trick for fixing dizziness. Sometimes these calcium deposits in your ear can get stuck and make you feel like you're spinning when you're actually not. A healthcare professional can help by moving your head in a certain way to unstick these calcium deposits. And in this way, your dizziness can be fixed. Another condition called Meniere's disease can be also a cause of vertigo. It is a chronic issue related to fluid buildup in the inner ear. It almost feels like a water balloon getting too full. When this happens, you might experience sudden dizziness where it feels like you are on a spinning amusement park ride. Plus, your ear can act up, causing hearing loss, a ringing sound or sounds, or feeling of fullness. Episodes can be quite severe, lasting minutes to hours and often accompanied by nausea and vomiting. Meniere's is lifelong, but there are treatments that can effectively manage these symptoms. Vestibular neuritis, often known as labyrinthitis, is linked to a viral infection causing inflammation around the balance maintaining nerve. In this disease, a sneaky virus messes with your balance system in your inner ear, and it can make you feel like you're spinning and having trouble standing, and you will feel a bit sick. You might have symptoms such as sudden vertigo, nausea, vomiting, and difficulties walking. The good news is your body can fight off the virus and things can go back to normal. Vestibular migraine is another cause of vertigo. So a vestibular migraine is like double trouble headache. You see, it's not only about the pounding headache pain, it also messes with your balance and makes you feel dizzy. Imagine having a regular migraine with a headache and then add in some extra special effects. You might suddenly feel like you are on a spinning carnival ride and you're getting nauseous or you have trouble standing up straight. The tricky part is that these symptoms can come and go and make it all feel like a bit of a roller coaster ride. But the good news is that there are treatments and strategies to help manage these symptoms. There are many other causes for vertigo. For example, vertigo can be also caused by head injuries, specific medications, and brain-related issues like strokes or multiple sclerosis, and there are many others. It's important to recognize that each of these causes requires distinct approaches to diagnosis and management. Well, if you experience vertigo alongside concerning symptoms such as severe headache, fever, double vision, trouble speaking or hearing, weakness, or any difficulty walking, you should seek immediate medical attention. These signs may indicate potentially serious issues. Moreover, if you're an old adult, especially if you're age 60 or above, having a history of a stroke or having risk factors for a stroke, it's advisable to consult a healthcare professional if your vertigo persists for several minutes or even more. For those who experience intermittent vertigo without these serious symptoms, it's still crucial to make an appointment with your healthcare professional. During the visit, they will perform a physical examination and inquire about your symptoms and medical history. This includes checking your eyes, balance, and gait, and hearing. Let's talk about vertigo treatment. In most cases, vertigo is bothersome but not indicative of a severe problem. The goal of treatment is to address the underlying cause, if it's known, relieve symptoms, and aid in recovery. Disease-specific treatment is recommended when the cause of vertigo is identified. It may involve medications, procedures, or lifestyle adjustments tailored to the underlying condition. For instance, BPPV can be effectively treated with the Epley maneuver, while Meniere's disease often benefits from non-surgical treatments. If you experience severe or prolonged vertigo episodes, your doctor might recommend medication to relieve the associated symptoms like vomiting. Medications can include antihistamines, anti-nausea drugs, or sedatives. However, these symptoms should be used cautiously as they can make you drowsy. Vestibular rehabilitation is a valuable approach to recovery. It helps your brain adapt to changes in the vestibular system, potentially speeding up your healing process. This therapy typically involves exercises that can be practiced at home, keeping in mind that staying still for too long can hinder your long-term recovery. And if you reached this far in the video, congratulations. I'm just going to go into some detail about treatment strategies for benign paroxysmal positional vertigo. One of them is the Epley maneuver. I've already mentioned this earlier in the video, and this is a set of special head movements that can help fix the trouble in your inner ear. It's like a real life puzzle game. When you move your head in specific ways, it makes these tiny particles in your ear, which are causing dizziness, go back to where they should be. Another maneuver is the CMOT maneuver. And this is similar to the Epley maneuver, and you can do specific head and body movements to kick those pesky particles out of your inner ear. There are also exercises called Brandt-Darrow exercises. And these exercises you can do at home to help your body get used to fake signals your inner ear is sending. Your health provider might put you on medications to alleviate your symptoms. However, you should know that these medications are more commonly used for symptoms such as nausea and dizziness rather than treating the very condition itself. In other words, the medications are there for symptom management. And the other thing you can do for yourself at home is to make sure that you make changes to your home environment that can help reduce the risk of injury during vertigo episodes. For instance, you can remove loose rugs, declutter the areas where you move around a lot, install handrails. And if you're interested in another video, just click right here or click right here. Have a good day and think your health. I think it is so. Why is it so slow?